Hey, what's up? My name is Kasia Gala. I'm a founder of Geek Go Chic, and this is Fashion Tech 101, where I talk about the new technologies that can be applied in fashion industry. If you are interested in tech-related topics and want to use it in your fashion brand, or you are doing new technologies and want to know how to apply them in this industry, just go ahead and subscribe to my channel. You can also like this video and follow me on social media. Today I'm gonna discuss one of my favorite topics, the one that I actually talk about in every episode of Fashion Tech 101, and this is AI. The coolest thing about AI is that there is actually no such thing as general artificial intelligence. AI is intelligence demonstrated by machines. These are abilities of algorithms to take actions and solve problems in order to achieve some kind of goals. Machine learning means that machines are training and learning to solve these problems in order to achieve goals they have to achieve. Deep learning is the approach to machine learning inspired by the way our brains look like and work. It is inspired on its structure and the way of interconnecting neurons. Before I move to AI in fashion, I will try to answer the question that you will probably have in mind and even want to ask in the comment section below. And the question is, will we ever achieve general artificial intelligence? And the answer is, I have no idea. There are some people who think that we'll have AI with IQ 1000 or even 10,000, and the other think that it is impossible to have AI as intelligent as that. And in fact, it actually doesn't matter. It is a trend that we cannot stop, and the things that we should think about is how we can use it in some industry and how we can use this to make the world a better place. So the thing that matters is how we can use artificial intelligence in fashion right now and in the future. So here are 10 ways of how fashion industry use and will use artificial intelligence in the future. The first use of AI is the flow of customers between brick and mortar stores and e-commerce. In the real world, it may look like this. We are in a store and see some things. We look at the products, go from place to place, and AI analyzes what we do, where we look at, and later it gives us offerings with mailings or banners, or show us different products on websites. The second use case is something that we witness in Amazon Go store in Seattle. So we go to the store, we take some product, and then we leave the store and all the payment is being done in an app. In this use case, AI analyzes image from cameras, data from sensors like beacons or weight, and that's how AI knows whether we bought some product or not. The other example of AI in fashion is something that is already happening. Facebook and Google and some of e-commerces already know what we like on social media, how we behave on the internet, and gives us recommendations based on that. The way that e-commerce can use this type of data is showing us different products on website or sending different mailings. This type of content and product personalization can go even further. And this leads us to the fourth example of how to use AI in fashion industry. Based off the knowledge about our age, race, gender, the place where we live, what we already bought, and many other data, AI can show us different kind of photos and models with different clothes and even different models with the same clothes. We already have software available that allows retailers to personalize photos without making many photo shoots with one item. The example is Looklet that allows to use many pack shots and collect them in one beautiful photograph. And the other startup is Vid, which uses AI for editing video in order to make better content for e-commerce. So talking about personalization, we go to the fifth point, is the personalization of products. If we combine AI with 3D printing and other technologies that allow to automate fashion production, we can achieve a mass personalization of products. It is not only about sizes, but also about colors, monograms, and many other ways that it can personalize product that we see in e-commerce and buy online, but even offline. The great exemplification of that is Ivy Revel collaboration with Google and their dress that is fully personalized on a customer's behavior and the things she likes. The other use case of AI in fashion is analyzing and predicting demand for products. Based on what was in fashion in the past and what are the social changes, our behaviors on the internet, AI will predict what kind of clothes we'll like to have in the future and what kind of product will be the must-have in the next few months. Now, many companies based on trend forecasting agencies' work and reports, like the one that WGSN is creating. But we already have tools like Edited, which help retailers to decide what kind of products they should produce in the future. And companies like H&M Group and Inditex are already working on their AI that can predict trends for them. Use case number 7 is AI in wearables. And it is one of my favorite examples of how our industry can actually use technology in order to expand our business models. Like I was talking in wearables episode, in the future, clothes will help us to be better and healthier people, and it will all happen thanks to AI. Example number 8 is the way we communicate with retailers in brick and mortar stores and also in e-commerce. Even now, we predict that in 2020, 50% of online searches will be done with using voice interface. That means that customers will not have to use keyboard or even touch their phones to purchase some kind of products. If you have seen Google Assistant at work or even Amazon Alexa, you are probably sure this is very doable in the future. So in the age when AI will be helping us to communicate with retailers, it will also help us to decide what kind of products we can buy. So we will be able to communicate with AI and it will behave as it was our personal stylist, personal shopper. It will tell us what kind of product fits us, what will be trendy in the future, what we should buy, and it will be the way of communicating with retailers. Personal stylists like this will use many data like weather, things we like to buy, things we wear, things we already have in our stock, and we'll make recommendations based on that kind of data. And taking one step forward, AI will be able to purchase some products for us. We all have this one clothing or shoes or accessories that we like to buy, for example, once a year. Like, I really love to buy Converse shoes every year. So wouldn't that be nice if I wouldn't have to go to e-commerce or real store and buy it myself if I know my size and preferences of the colors? So AI could do that for me. Okay, so tell me, what do you think about using artificial intelligence in fashion? Where do you see the better use case for that? And do you think that we can achieve general artificial intelligence? Do you think that we are all gonna die? If you enjoyed this video, please like it and subscribe if you are interested in fashion tech. I am Kasia Gola and this was Fashion Tech 101. See you next week. A myślę minutę, więc mogę robić co chcę. Ale mam zakwasiki, więc nie mogę.